Welcome to the Brain Coffee Podcast, where Drs. Eric Luthard and Albert Kim unlock life's little mysteries about health, wellness, entertainment, technology, and how the brain makes sense of it all. Sit back, relax, and open up your mind.
How's it going with the second dog?
Oh yeah, we just got this puppy a month ago. It's been like literally the longest month in the last few years. It's just
kind of like a newborn.
It's just the problem is a newborn. I mean, it's worse than a newborn. Newborn stays put, right? So this puppy pees in the bed, pees in the bathroom, pees on the couch, and it's ridiculous, you know. And I think it's happy doing it. It knows when I'm leaving, and it purposely wants to irk me. And
so, do you think it's really happy? Do you think your dog has true emotions?
I think she does. I think they both do, both of my dogs. I'm not sure if they're aware of that. Happiness, sadness. I do think they probably get depressed if you keep them caged up for long periods of time. I mean, you've had dogs before.
Yeah, no, I've had two border collies, and they're amazingly aware of your emotions.
Yeah,
sure. Like, I think they certainly can appreciate your emotions and respond to them. And it seems that they express, but it's an interesting, question of, again, it starts to get, a level of sentience and consciousness.
Yeah,
and,
right.
And when you have a dog, I think it's a gray area.
I agree. Well, whether or not they know, whether or not they have true emotion and they're aware of it, mm-hmm. over time and evolution, there's been this circuit that has been modified and strengthened between humans and dogs. I mean, Actually, they've talked about this in papers.
Well, like, they have done functional MRIs in dogs and show that, when they see the face of their masters, like their pleasure circuits go up.
Interesting. So the paper I remember is related to this. Actually, uh-huh. It's that when dogs look into their owner's eyes, there's some surge. I think it's the oxytocin circuit.
Oh, I do.
That goes
remember.
Up. Yeah, and that's different from more primitive canines like wolves who won't look at
human's eyes
as much.
That's right.
I think dogs have evolved to just gaze into our eyes, and that strengthens the relationship.
It's the love circuit,
some extent that gets activated in both individuals on both sides, and that strengthens their relationship.
Actually, there was a really funny experiment. So there's a linguist who had two border collies, mm-hmm. and he trained his border, so this isn't quite emotion, but it's uh-huh. kind of tangential to that.
Okay.
But, he trained his border collie to know the names of 1,000 different stuffed animals.
1,000?
1,000.
Smart dog.
Border collies are the smartest dogs by far. I had two of them, and that's both good and bad. But anyway. And he would say, okay, find me, kind of Ripley, or find me Einstein, or find me, Johnny. And the dog would go behind a couch and pick out the correct one.
Amazing.
Then what he did, he would introduce a new stuffed animal that had a new name, and the dog had never encountered that.
Uh-huh.
And then he'd say, okay, find me Joey. Again, there was never a Joey named stuffed animal. And then the dog would go back and then pick it out and because it was the new one that he didn't know the name of. And he would infer that must be Joey.
That's fascinating.
It's really cool.
What if they gave him two of them?
Could it actually
figure it out, or was it just by... by elimination.
I think it was elimination. But even still, that's pretty good.
I don't know if I know 1,000 people's names, quite honestly.
Yeah, right.
That's amazing.
At a cocktail party, yeah, exactly. I think we both suffered from that.